To me, the job of a developer is to imagine an environment in which people will be delighted with the way that they can live in that environment. To see the land as it is and what is naturally present, what the natural ecology of the land is, and to bring to it the idea of the human ecology and the needs of human beings if they are to occupy this land in a way that's satisfying to them. The interesting feature of the outcome is that the houses don't occupy all of the land evenly. That is, they've been grouped together. So the housing is focused in areas in which housing is most suitably placed on the site. As well as that, we were interested in what views were available around the land. So as you turn around, we've got the Arthur Range here, we've got the Richmond Range there, we've got views over the Waimea Plains and the hills that rise from the plains. And we've got some distant estuary and coastal views as well. Small, low impact roads was what we had our heart set on. Roads that wouldn't require much modification of the ground. The objective is to put the stormwater back to the ground, the rainwater back to the ground as quickly as possible. There's two advantages of that. One is it helps to treat the water running off the roads, which has a certain amount of contaminants in it. This also means that the water gets to soak into the ground a little bit as it goes. We've also got a water system here that belongs to this community, a registered private water scheme. Simone said to me a few weeks ago or months ago, the water is just fantastic. This is the best water I've ever drunk. It comes out of the ground from 350 metres below the surface. It's pumped into a holding tank. It's provided to the houses at pressure. Once the water has been through the house and therefore into the wastewater system, it goes to the wastewater treatment plant. It's treated to a possibly an unnecessarily high standard. And then it's applied back to the ground again. It's returned to the land as a resource. It becomes part of the processes which are going on in the soils and in the ground around here. One of the first things we did was begin to plant native shrubs, native species, especially those suited to wetter areas, in the gullies. And we started from the side of the land that we would first develop, and that is steadily moving across the property. In the first 2 years, we planted 6,000 to 8,000 native plants, and some of those plants now, 4 or 5 years later, are actually quite substantial, and a great pleasure to be able to see them growing in and protecting those gullies. Those tanks you see in the distance are firefighting tanks. There's a total of 46 cubic metres of storage, which is enough to fight a house fire. Each stage of the subdivision has two tanks. None of these houses sites will ever be able to be re-subdivided. There's an agreement with every other person on this property that you cannot subdivide your land. We have young families on the site already. We have retired couples. We have couples who are still working. We have a really good initial mix of occupants. Dave said to me last week, he said, "We are so pleased. We're just thrilled to be living here." ¶¶
Thank you.